It's less than, 1919, I think, when we first welcomed the first woman MP, Astor, who we saw in that video, Nancy Astor. How do you think things have changed for women in Parliament in that time?
Yeah, I mean, I think the culture has changed, but the pace of change sometimes feels glacially slow. So, I mean, when I take people on a tour of the House of Commons, I was doing one this morning, you come through an arch that's been there since 1099. So, I mean, from 1099 to 1919 is a long time. And it took up till 1918 for people to recognise women are intelligent enough to put an X in a box every 5 years. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I'm very proud to say I'm part of the most diverse parliament ever. One in three MPs is now a woman. I think it's the gayest parliament ever, the most BME parliament ever. But, you know, we could still go a lot further on things like disability. And one in three is not the same...
Not with the building you've got at the moment. It's hopeless.
Well, I mean, yeah, there's... I mean, even
it's
in
1990... It's crumbling, basically, isn't it?
You yes, falling have to move down. That quite I show them that as well, all the holes in the ceiling yeah. where it's literally, you can see it caving in. But, I mean, it's not enough to just pat ourselves on the back and say, job done, because one in three is not the same as 50-50, which it should be if it reflects our population. So, I mean, I think in 1997, when we had 101 Labour women MP elected in the tide of Blairism...
Was that Blair's babes?
Yeah, that's okay. them. Yeah, some of them are still around.
I didn't
around.
Like that phrase particularly, did you? No.
Yeah, I mean, I'm 45 years old. I couldn't be a babe ever, but...
OK, we're not doing age, OK?
Age. But, I mean, the point is they had to convert a lot of toilets into women's toilets because it just wasn't there before. The infrastructure... The whole setup of it is like a gentleman's club. Mm. The sort of way that we refer to each other, I'm the Honourable Lady for Ealing Central and Acton, it's really bad to refer to someone by their name. You get really slapped down and frowned upon. So this Victorian play acting that we have in the House of Commons, some of those structures, you know, they... I mean, tradition is good, but, I mean, some of them for the sake of it. And then also recently we've had debates on things like baby leave, because MPs who have kids while they're in there... I mean, I did all that before I was elected... there are these sort of things like they vote for you, they work for you, that they sort of count, they audit every time an MP votes. So colleagues of mine who've had kids, they've been rated by The Sun as the laziest MP in England or whatever. And it's because you have to go through a physical lobby, you know, the strictures and structures that you have to do. There should be some ways around that, because it's not that they're slumming it, you know, it's for
yeah,
legitimate
you're talking
reasons.
About a men's club. Can I bring in Lucy Giles?
MPs pay the same.
Yeah, I mean, our basic salary is the same and it's very transparent and open what we're paid. But I think there was a report recently that showed that with all the outside earnings, men earn more. So they often will have a second job lawyering or something like that. Whereas I think with all these arguments, we've got to look also at the workplace. Why is it always the woman's fault for not asking? Mm-hmm. If you're in a job where it's macho men in suits and if you stay all the hours God sends, then you're a good employee, that is not conducive to going home to do bedtime, you know, the sort of thing I do, I'll be doing tonight, whereas a man wouldn't. You know, men are carers too, they're parents too, but the onus is often on the woman, isn't it?
So, yes,
I mean, I think we need to look at our workplaces because these structures and cultures are designed by men for men, aren't they?
You so, have a you creche, know. Don't you, in the...
Actually, yeah, there is a House of Commons nursery, but then there's issues about between nursery age and school age. Do you know what I mean? Like, there's
I thought you were going to do a gag about it being the chamber then, so I'll do it instead. Ladies, no, who's got a view? You're on the face a little bit. I mean, how ridiculous is that? Do you still find that in the corridors of power?
I think probably in the world of politics, people will think twice. Because if you think about it, the expenses scandal... sort of, as a result of that, we've now got procedures in place for claiming expenses, whereas before that... You know, when Michael Fallon said that times are different now to 10 to 15 years ago, I think what he meant is you could get away with more 10 to 15 years ago. Men will do what they can get away with, whereas now we've got a system for financial impropriety. Do you know what I mean? I was elected in 2015. I'm never going to claim for a duck house or a bath plug or a Mars bar, because I'm very aware it's all going to be published. But up until then, there was no transparency in all that. So, I mean, if that's what it took to have a proper system, I think it was a good thing. It was, you know, unpleasant to hear about it, but it was a necessary thing.
The first thing I asked
David Cameron in the House of Commons in 2015 when I was first elected was, would he call himself, because you're not allowed to refer to people by name, you're not allowed to say you, that's really bad in the House of Commons. So would he call himself a feminist? And he said, well, if it means equality for women, yes, of course I am, because 30% of my cabinet are women. Like, I'm no statistician, but 70-30 is not 50-50. 50-50, is it? But, I mean, the point is, it is laudable aims to be associated with. I think people that have given it a bad press, associating it with dungarees and bra burning and spare rib and all that, you've got to look at who those people are propagating those arguments. And it's usually the sort of people who don't want women to lift themselves up at all. People who don't
Let me bring in the ladies in uniform. Yeah.